Welcome to this Fast 15 on Workday, viewing and changing your personal information. We're going to cover viewing your personal information in Workday and actually making some changes. Workday is essentially your personnel file. It replaces the paper personnel file that is now currently behind a locked cabinet in HR, placing it available for you 24/7 online through Workday. For the purposes of today, I'm using a fictional HR employee, Steve Rogers. So your screen will look a little bit different. And everyone's will look different to some extent, because depending on who you are in Workday, maybe you are a manager or an employee, your applications will look different. But everyone will share the same set of information, and that is the W on the left-hand side of the screen, which always returns to your homepage. This is good if you're in personal information and you get lost in some of Workday's many menus. You can always click on the blue W in the top left-hand corner to return to your home page. For the purposes of today's Fast 15, I have a cloud in the upper right-hand corner of my screen. If I had uploaded a personal photo to Workday, however, the cloud would show this personal photo. If you click on the cloud, you will get another menu, and you can view your profile. When you click on View Profile, you come to a summary page, which will show some general information regarding your work location, who your managers or manager is, and some basic job details. Where do you work? What your position is? Your business title, in other words, your working title. In Workday, there are definitely some new terminology changes that state employees will need to learn, and one of these is business title, which is another term for your working title. Then you have your job profile. Again, another terminology change. This is simply your job classification. Are you a compliance specialist, a human resource analyst, or an education specialist? That is what will show in your job profile. And then you will get some other information regarding your position, your hire date, your continuous service date, which is your recognized service date, the date you started with state service, your length of service time and position, and time and job profile. Your summary screen will show some basic information about your job, including some education and work contact information. On the overview page, you can dig into a little bit more detail. You'll get to the same job details screen, and that includes the same information I showed on the first screen. But you now have a set of tabs up at the top of your screen, including personal information, manager history, compensation, contact, and IDs. I'll take a moment to step through these. Your personal information will include some basic demographic information, and typically this is what somebody would input when they are applying for a job with the state and filling out that state job application. Manager history will show me who I've reported to over my career. And I also have a compensation tab. This will give me my actual compensation that I received in the position. For Steve, it lists total base pay, what his salary grade is, his grade profile, what step he is at, and this should look a little bit familiar. This is the same information we currently have for our classification and compensation. Then Steve will have something called plan assignments. Steve will see he receives his base salary, a compensation plan that says monthly salary prorated for less than full time. This essentially means Steve is a full-time employee. All permanent full-time employees will have this designation. So don't worry if you see that monthly salary prorated for less than full time. It does not mean you're getting paid for less than full time. It just means that you are a permanent full-time employee receiving a monthly salary. Had you been part-time or worked less than full hours, that amount would be prorated. Plan assignments would also show any work out of class or lead work differentials or other differentials Steve might have. Then we come to the contact information. On your contact information screen, you are going to get two sets of tables. One is your home contact information and your work contact information. And this is where we come to the change part of the webinar, because now you see an edit button at the top of the screen. Of course, I can't change my compensation or my job details, but I do have control over contact information. For this example, let's say Steve, after he applied for and received a job with the department, needed to change his information. When he clicks Edit, you can see we have two options, Change Home Contact Information and Change Work Contact Information. If I click Change Home Contact Information, I come to the Edit screen. It shows me that my primary address is 123 Anywhere Street in Anywhere, Oregon. And if I wanted to change that, I simply click on the pencil icon on the right-hand side of the screen. This will be similar to pretty much any other screen in Workday where you have the option to edit information. You only see this pencil or this X to remove the data. If I click on the pencil, I can input an effective date. Effective dates are important in Workday because let's say I know I'm moving, but I won't close on that house or I won't get into that apartment until later on down the line. But I do know what my new address is. I can say that it is for April 1st, 2019, when I know I'll be moving. I can go ahead and input the new address, and you'll notice that there are red asterisks on these different fields. This means it is required. Workday will not let me continue until I input information into these fields that are marked with the red asterisk. Scrolling down, Workday asks me for some basic information. We can add some notes. This could be for myself. And after I'm done with my home address, I can also input my phone number, if I have one, an email address, a personal email address, or even instant messenger or web address information if I wanted that. Now, as you recall, we started to change home contact information. This is personal information. Who would see this information would be, of course, you as an employee, and then your manager and HR. This is really no different than it is today with those paper files. However, it's now online, but this is still private personal contact information. After I'm all done entering my information, I simply submit and I get the green check mark. This is important in Workday because I'll get a green check mark whenever something I do is successfully completed. If this needed some sort of approval, let's say HR needed to approve it or a manager, it would say somebody in HR was up next or my manager was up next. But for a personal contact information change, no approval is needed. You can do that yourself. Then Workday takes me back to my contact information screen, and you can see here that I still have a primary address, but if you remember, I put in an effective date of April 1st, 2019, because that's when I knew I was moving to Workday with both of those, but it says, hey, your new address is going to be effective 4/1, and until that date comes, I'm still going to have that 123 Anywhere Street address. Once 4/1/2019 comes about, Workday will automatically switch that and the 456 Today Street address will be the only one showing. I can also change my work contact information and it's a very similar process. I can change my business address if I move locations, although this should typically automatically update through HR processes. But I can also add my work phone number. If that changes, if I get a new desk, I can add my work phone number. I can also add my work email, for example, if I had a name change. But work contact information is treated a little bit differently because work contact information is viewable across the enterprise. So a state government employee could log in, do a Workday search for your name and see where you work, what your email address is, and what your work phone number is. However, if this did need to be protected for whatever reason through an HR process, it could certainly be made private. Again, that would typically be done by working through HR. However, for the most part, employees that with work contact information, that information will be available to anyone with a Workday account, which is a state government employee. The public does not have access to Workday. Finally, I have a couple more tabs. I can see my employee IDs. This will include my PEB ID number and a RACF ID number if I need that for my job. I will also have a More tab, which will give me a few more menus. I have my support roles, which is useful to see who in HR I might need to contact, for example, recruitment purposes or for safety purposes. I can also see my worker history, which is essentially a detailed history of the Workday actions that were ever taken on me as an employee. For Steve, you can see he was hired. He did some onboarding information like federal tax elections, his I-9 form. He managed his educational info, changed his emergency contacts. And this will show again a very detailed step-by-step table of all the information that was ever changed or started for Steve. I also have my timeline, which is a summary of the worker history, but this timeline is essentially my education and work history. It simplifies it a little bit. Again, with Steve, we see he was hired on February 15th, but he also attained some education before that. He got his bachelor's degree in 2008. And if I had more information here that I wanted to see, I could filter down the timeline to just narrow down on things like jobs, assignments, and pay changes. On the left-hand side of the screen, I do have some more tabs, which will essentially replicate the tab on the overview menu that are at the top of the screen. We've covered how to view and change your personal information in Workday in this webinar. Again, your personal information is accessible through the cloud by left-clicking and viewing profile. And this information is essentially your personnel file, which includes your job details, personal and work contact information, training, education, as work history. As part of Workday, you do have ownership of your personal and work contact information. You can change this yourself anytime you want, again, online. Thank you, everyone, for attending this Fast 15. Have a great day.